In Springfield, they're eating the dogs, the people that came in. They're eating the cats. They're eating the pets of the people that live there. And this is what's happening in our country, and it's a shame.
ABC News did reach out to the city manager there. He told us there have been no credible reports of specific claims of pets being harmed, injured, or abused by individuals.
Did you eat that cat? Did you eat it?
No, we pulled up and she was just laying there with me.
Did you see her eating it?
Eating it.
She was eating it?
Yeah, she was.
米国移民、他人のペットの犬猫を食らう。こんにちは、皆さん。エリトです。猫派としてマジギレしています。大統領選が間近で緊迫している米国ですが、最近ありました左翼メディア ABC が生放送したトランプ・カマラのディベートが今斜め上の炎上の仕方をしています。冒頭にもちょろっと流しましたが、ある箇所でトランプがオハイオ州では移民たちが人々のペットの犬猫を食べていると発言。なぜかカマラ氏はそれを聞いてニヤニヤしてたんですが、ファクトチェックのためにその場にいたモデレーターはこの発言に対し、現地ではそんな報告はなかったときっぱり否定。しかし現地民を取材した YouTuber の動画、警察のボディカメラや通信記録には全く別のことが映っていて、移民の生活保護問題なども浮き彫りになってしまい、大統領選とかそういうレベルじゃないほどアメリカが今カオスになってます。先日ハイチ人と思われる男性が野生のダチョウを持ち帰る画像が拡散されていたので、トランプの言葉を信じるという人が多いようですね。前回のバイデン贔屓のディベートもさることながら、今回のやり方もひどいって言われてるんですが、メディアが偏っていることも含め、この問題は日本の移民問題や川口市のクルド人問題と似ているところがあると思うので、最後まで見てほしいです。高評価ぜひお願いします。まず冒頭にも流しました左翼的 ABC ニュースのディベートの後、多くの左翼メディアがトランプは移民に対してペットを食べるなどステレオタイプ的な発言をしたと彼を批判し、カマラが優勢かというような報道をしたんです。ご覧いただいている通り、有名メディアがこぞってトランプを袋叩きにしている状況なんですが、先日オハイオ州警察のボディカメラの動画がアップされて、そこでは実際に猫を食べた女性が逮捕される様子が映されていて、これが事実だったということが判明しています。それがこちらです。
Why do you care?Smile for me. Smile with your teeth. Go like this. Did you eat that cat? Did you eat it? No, why did you guys see all this?
No, we pulled up and she was just laying there with me.
Did you see her eating it?
Eating it.
She was eating it?
Yeah, she was.
You call the Humane Society to see if they'll come pick this cat up. It's deceased.
さて、今ネット上ではこの女性がハイチ人かどうかという議論がされてるんですが、実際にハイチ人がペットの猫をさらっているという報告は何度もされていたんです。その時の音声がこちらです。
I'm standing here, I'm riding on the trail and I see a group of Haitian people, there was about four of them, they all had geese in their hand, they got away, I couldn't make out the first three of the license plateBut I got the numbers. The last numbers was 9898, and it was a gray Toyota Tacoma they took off on. There was about four of them. There was two men, two women.
左翼はこの音声は AI だろうと言ってますが、実際のレポートも合わせて提出されているので、この音声は信憑性がかなり高いと言われています。この状況に対して共和党副大統領候補のバンス氏もペットを食べる移民について以前語っていました。
I would say is he brought up this misleading false claim that you yourself have talked about in recent days about Haitian immigrants in Springfield, Ohio abducting people's pets and eating them, which officials there have said is not true. You yourself acknowledged it may be false on Twitter. You still told people to keep spreading it. But Trump just amplified it to tens of millions of people who were watching. Why?Push something that's not true.
Well, first of all, city officials have not said it's not true. They've said they don't have all the evidence.
They said they have no evidence.
We've heard from a number of constituents on the ground, Caitlin, who both firsthand and secondhand reports saying this stuff is happening. So they very clearly, meaning the people on the ground dealing with this, think that it is happening. And I think that it's important for journalists to actually get on the ground and uncover this stuff for themselves when you have a lot of people saying, my pets are being abducted, or geese at the city pond are being abducted and right in front of us. This is crazy stuff. And again, whether those exact rumors turn out to be mostly true, somewhat true, whatever the case may be. Caitlin, this town has been ravaged by 20,000 migrants coming in. Healthcare costs are up. Housing costs are up. Communicable diseases like HIV and TB have skyrocketed in this small Ohio town. This is what Kamala Harris's border policies have done. And I think it's interesting, Caitlin, that the media didn't care about the carnage wrought by these policies until we turned it into a meme about cats. And that speaks to the media's failure to care about what's going on in these communities. If we have to meme about it to get the media to care, we're going to keep on doing it because the media should care about what's going on.
この一連の動きを見ていた移民賛成派の左翼は、これをプロパガンダだと叫んでいるようですが、過激な現場に潜入することで知られる YouTuber オリビエが、実際に現地人、ハイチ人にインタビューしていた時の様子がこちらです。
There was Haitians in a white van driving around the neighborhoods collecting cats, skinning them and eating them. They're getting thousands of dollars in government assistance, even the cash assistance cards. They're calling them the magic money cards because they never run out.
Man, they're nothing but a headache. All they're doing is raising our rent and our taxes and wrecking vehicles.
Everybody wants to make this into a race issue. It's not a race issue. It's culture, it's accountability, and it's respect.
Since June, they took me off of, I'm a vet. They took me off of the disability.
You're a veteran and you're competing with some of the resources they're getting and just came in here?
Yeah.
I need some solutions. I'm losing my mind.
We've lost a whole bunch of cats. There was a van load of a van pulled over that had over 100 cats in it with the Haitians. They said they was eating them.
Actually?
Yeah.
Not fake news.
Not fake news.
So a van was collecting cats and eating them.
I watched it happen, yeah. Watched them get pulled over with the cats and admit to the police that they was eating them.
You're not joshing with me.
No, I'm almost 50 years old, buddy. I don't, nah.
You don't mess around.
No.
Saying that Haitians are kidnapping the neighbor's cats and eating them. Is that true or false? I gotta ask the hard questions here.
No.
It's ridiculous. They can't even take care of the American citizens before they're bringing in waves and waves of immigrants. And then look at it. There's so many people, veterans, mostly white people, that are homeless, living on the streets, has nothing to eat. But these people have brand new houses, brand new cars. I'm having a hell of a time finding a job because they want the Haitian. They're getting thousands of dollars in government assistance. I worked retail before I lost my job back in April. When I do transactions, I can see what comes across on certain cards. I'm not trying to be nosy. I don't want to know what you get. But when a Haitian comes through and spends $500 in food stamps and still has $5,000 on their food assistance card.
$5,000?
$5,000. Would you like to know what the Haitians are calling the food assistance cards? They're calling them the magic money cards because they never run out. I'm homeless. I'm jobless. I'm sleeping on friends' couches because I can't get government assistance because I come from the wrong country, apparently. 90% of the auto accidents are Haitian involved.
Okay.
And I've almost gotten hit by several of them walking because I walk a lot and they're going the wrong way down one-way streets, like, and they think they own the streets. And when they got chased out, he hit the curb.
Look at them, just blasted off.
They've knocked down my grandmother's fence.
Yeah, well, I've seen a video of a guy getting a Canadian goose, a Haitian dude, and I have rumors of Haitians taking cats. Tell me what's going on here.
I'm worried. My town is going to pot. Everybody wants to make this into a race issue. It's not a race issue. It's culture, it's accountability, and it's respect. And that's the things that I'm not seeing. And the women in this country have fought long and hard for the rights that they have been afforded. And these men in this culture treat their women very badly, and I watch it firsthand. Come on, give me a break. Start acting like you got some sense. The driving of the vehicles is a main sticking point. So it's they've thrown trash in the yard as they walk by. I'm done. I'm tired of dealing with the disrespect. I've never been so disrespected in my life, and my ex-husband has never disrespected me like this. They're not prosecuting for the proper, and it's just, it's a big mess and we need some help. I want my city back. I want my people happy and this is my town.
現地人はもう怒り疲れたというような感じで、 移民がオハイオ州で好き勝手する様子が、川口や日本全国で好き勝手する移民たちと重なってとても悲しく感じました。最後に実際に被害に遭った女性のインタビュー動画を見ていきましょう。
There's been a lot of allegations of animals going missing. You know, ducks being basically taken. Yes, sir.
There's pictures of that too.
Can you speak on that? Have you ever seen that in person?
I've seen, the only thing I've seen, I did see a pig's head laying down in Snyder Park.
You saw a pig's head?
A pig's head.
Like it had been cut off? Or?
Yes, sir.
Wow. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, that's, you don't really see that every day, do you?
No, you don't. It's kind of surprising.
Wow.
But then our city wants to pass it off as cult stuff.
As cult stuff?
Yeah.
Do you think that has anything to do with, you know, like the connections with voodoo that Haitians commonly have? I mean, in Haiti,
well,
it's a very
actually,
commonly practiced thing.
I'm sorry. There's actually been a couple people that I know that have been told that they were going to be cursed by voodoo.
By Haitians?
By Haitians.
So that actually is a real thing here?
Yes.
Them practicing voodoo with animals,
yes.
Pig's head?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
There are adult, I'm sorry, they're from 19 to 23 years old going to our high school.
That's a little unusual. I don't think I've ever heard that before.
My 10-year-old granddaughter has a 16-year-old in her class.
Wow.
Yeah.
Does that raise safety concerns for you?
It raises many safety concerns for me. And like I said, all the women and...
Well, then you had mentioned about, you know, being in the past. Could you explain that as well?
Yeah. A Haitian guy was following me around the store. Literally following me. I asked him once, why are you following me? He smiled and turned his back. The second time he came down the aisle, he was up against my rear end. And I pushed back from him and I said, what are you doing? And he said, no, understand English. So I pulled up my shirt and said, do you understand that? And he left. Our city commission, our mayors, our people that we pay to protect us, the police, their hands are tied. I mean, everybody's complaining because the police aren't doing nothing, but they can't. Biden and Harris gave these people complete immunity, complete amnesty. So their hands are tied. So we're on our own here. And then they get on the news and they say that we're lying about...
という感じですが、皆さんどう思いましたか？ハイチ人が猫の調理方法を紹介している動画などがネット上でバズってるんで、ハイチ人は完全に悪だという印象がついてしまったようです。この全体的な状況は日本といくつか共通点があると感じましたが、未だにこのオハイオ州の小さな町に留まっている状況は全米に広がると思います。ヨーロッパでも今そんな感じですから、日本でも起こりうる未来です。それを防ぐためには僕らは何をすべきでしょうか？皆さんの考えをコメント欄から教えてください。それでは良い一日を。